So all are getting my voice on screen. Please respond. In previous classes, we discussed about what is Python. What are the different versions are available in Python? And each version, what are the new features are came in each version? And we have seen the difference between Python program with other programming languages like C program, C++, Java. So now you guys got the clarity, which programming language is the easiest programming language. So you guys got the clarity, Python is easiest programming language or not when compared with other programming languages. So in today's session, I'm going to talk about features of Python. What features are there in Python? I'm going to talk about what features are there in Python. Here we have several features are there in Python. We'll discuss one by one. First one is Python is simple and easy programming language. Python is simple and easy programming language. Python is simple and easy programming language. But here, if you compare syntaxes of Python with any other programming language syntaxes, right? Python syntaxes are very easy. But here, if you want to declare any variable in Python, we don't need to specify the type explicitly. But coming to Python, compulsory we have to specify the type explicitly. And one more thing, right? In Python, semicolons are optional. If you go with other programming languages, semicolons are mandatory at the end of the statements. And if you go with the Python, for loops and if conditions all are just like English statements kind of thing. Means, readability is very easy in Python. But if you go with the other programming languages, right, we have to understand more in the for loops and if conditions and all the things like that. Syntaxes wise, Python syntaxes are very easy compared with other programming language syntaxes. So that's why here I'm saying Python is a simple and easy programming language. Anyone can able to learn Python. There is no dependency on other programming languages for learning Python. Without having any other programming knowledge, happily we can learn Python. So that's why here I'm saying Python is a simple and easy programming language. There is no dependency on other programming language. All Python syntaxes are simple. And one more thing, if you compare with other programming languages, in Python, the length of the code is very less. Whenever length of the code is reduced, automatically readability will get increased. Easily we can read the program, Python program, right? Second feature is, it is freeware and open source. Freeware and open source. What is meant by this freeware and open source? If you go for some programming languages like .NET, in .NET, .NET is Microsoft related. So in Microsoft, there is no anything like freeware kind of things. there is no way, no anything freeware. Everything is paid versions only in Microsoft. And if you want to develop any application by using .NET, you have to pay some amount to that Microsoft people. Then only you can able to use that software in your system. But coming to Python, happily we can develop small applications to big applications. We no need to pay single rupee also to anyone. Completely it's freeware. Python is completely freeware. Happily we can install Python in our system and we can develop any kind of applications. We no need to pay the money to anyone in Python. It's a completely free version. Freeware Python is completely free version. What about open source? Once you install Python software in your system, the source code is open to all. Open source. Source means source code. Whatever Guido wrote, that source code is open to all. Anyone can able to see that source code, what Guido wrote. The source code is available. Once you install Python in your system, source code is available. Anyone can able to see that source code. If you feel you are the more talented guy than Guido, if you want based on your requirement, you can customize that source code also. You can customize that source code also, and you can put your name for that language and you can release with your name. Understood what I'm telling? Open source means the source code is available. What Guido wrote, that the entire source code is available if you install Python in your system. Based on your programming requirement, if you want, you can modify that code also. Based on your programming requirement, based on your business requirements, if you want, you can modify that source code also. And you can put your name for that language and you can release with your name. If you observe, we have different flavors are there in Python, like C Python, J Python, Anaconda Python, Ruby Python, Iron Python, like that multiple flavors are there. J Python or Jython, what is that? So J Python or Jython is Java people are customized this Python programming language. Based on that Java requirements, Java people are customized this Python programming language and they put the name as JPython. They put the name JPython and released with Jython like that. Understood what I'm telling? Open source means once you install Python programming language in your system, we can able to see the source code. And based on your programming requirement, we can modify that source code also. Java people are modified that source code and they put their name as Jython or JPython. Like that, tomorrow, based on your requirement, you can modify that Python code. And you can put your name and you can release with your name to the market also. Clear this point. It is a freeware and open source. Freeware means we no need to pay any amount. It is completely free. Happily, we can develop small applications to big application. Open source means that source code is available. Source code is open to all. Based on your requirement, if you want, you can customize that source code also. Next point. First two points are clear. Python is a simple and easy programming language. Means anyone can able to learn Python. There is no dependency. There is no dependency on other programming languages. Right? Compare with other programming languages. Python syntaxes are very easy to understand. Next point. It is a freeware and open source. If you want to work with Python, right? Just you install Python software in your system, it is completely freeware. We no need to pay any money to any people. And next one is it is open source. It is open source. Means the source code. Source code means what? Original code. Source code in the sense original code. Whatever Guido wrote, that original code is open to all. If you want, you can customize that source code based on your programming requirement also. Next one. Next feature is Python is a high level programming language. Python is a high level programming language. What is high level? Already we discussed, and what is high level programming language and what is low level programming language. High level programming language in the sense anyone can able to understand, anyone can able to read it. High level language in the sense what? Being a programmer, we are not required to concentrate on low level activities. Low level activities, and happily we can able to read and happily we can able to understand it. It look like a normal English language. High level programming language in the sense it look like a normal English language. We can able to understand and we can able to read that one. Next point. Python is platform independent. Platform independent. What is this platform independent? What is a platform independent? Suppose if you go for C language and C++, if you go for C language and C++, those two programming languages are platform dependent programming languages. Platform dependent programming languages. C and C++ both are platform dependent programming languages. What is meant by platform dependent and platform independent? What is platform dependent and platform independent? Right. Platform dependent means, suppose today I'm writing one program in Windows operating system. Right. Now everything is fine. It is working. Tomorrow client came. He asked, "Hey, compare with Windows operating system. In Unix operating system, more features are there. Why can't we move from Windows operating system to Unix operating system?" Like that client asked. Right. Then what we have to say? Yes, we can move, sir, like that. Right. But here the problem is, again we have to modify the code. According to Unix operating system, we have to modify the code. Means what? Here, if you go with the C language and C++, here we are using a platform related compilers. Suppose if you are working with Windows operating system, we have to use Windows compiler. Suppose if you are working in Unix operating system, there we have to use Unix operating system related compiler. If you are working with the Linux operating system, there we have to use Linux operating system related compiler. Then at that time, what it will do, what compiler will do, it will convert the program from high level language to low level language. In that case, by using Windows compiler, you are converting the program from high level language to low level language. Then we have to use that file, whatever the converted file is there, we have to use that file only in Windows operating system only. It won't work for other operating systems. Tomorrow, if you change to Unix, then again you have to use a Unix compiler and again you have to convert the program from high level language to low level language in Unix operating system. That corresponding file only you have to use. Understood what I'm telling? Platform dependent means, here I am using Windows compiler. So according to that Windows compiler, we have to modify the code. Next, tomorrow if you move to Unix operating system, there we have to use Unix compiler. According to that Unix compiler, we have to modify the code. Means what, Andy? Our programming languages are depending on the platform. Depending on the platform, if you change the OS, if you change the operating system, according that we have to modify the code again. We have to modify the code again, and is nothing but platform dependent. If you change any operating system, according that we have to modify the code. We have to modify the code, and that is nothing but platform dependent. But coming to Java and Python, these programming languages are platform independent. platform independent. That here, today I am writing one program and I am writing one program. This is the Python program I am writing and where I am writing this Python program, where I am writing this Python program in Windows operating system. In Windows operating system, I am writing this program. In Windows operating system, I am writing this program. All right. I wrote this program in Windows operating system. Windows operating system. It is working fine in Windows operating system. Right. Tomorrow client came. Client asked, right, why in Unix we have more features? Why can't we move from Windows to Unix operating system? Like the client asked. In that case, without changing any code, same program we can run in a Unix operating system also. We no need to modify anything. Here we no need to modify anything. Happily we can run our application whatever we wrote in a Windows operating system. Same program we can run in Unix operating system also. Here, see, as it is, and this program, whatever we wrote, this same program we can run in a Unix operating system also. We no need to modify anything yet here. Anything yet here, and directly take your program and run in Unix operating system, it will work. And next, client came again and he asked, Ray, compare with Unix, we have more features in Linux. Then why we can't move with the Linux operating system? Happily, we can run this same program in Linux operating system also, it will work. Tomorrow, client asked Mac operating system. Yes, same program we can run in Mac also, it will work. We don't need to modify the code. We don't need to change anything inside our program. Happily, we can run same program in multiple environments. We can run same program in multiple environments without modifying the code. Such type of programming languages are called platform independent programming languages. Here, whenever we change the platform, at the time I am not modifying anything. There is no dependency on platform. You can use any platform, right? I can run my program in any operating system. I can run my program in any platform. Changes are not required. That this program will work in any operating system. Such kind of programming languages are called platform independent programming languages. Platform dependent means what? Suppose if you change the operating system, according that we have to modify the code. Today I am working with the Windows. So Windows one type of code I wrote. Tomorrow if you want to move with Unix, again you have to modify the code. Next day, if you want to work with Linux, again we have to modify the code. Next day, if you want to move with Mac, again we have to modify the code. Whenever we change that platform, at that time, every time we have to modify the code. If you go for platform dependent programming languages, platform independent means what? We no need to modify the code. Single program we can run in any operating system without changing my program, without changing my code. I can able to run my program in any operating system. Such kind of programming languages are called platform independent programming languages. Clear what is platform dependent and platform independent? Please respond. Python is platform independent. That means we can run our Python program in any operating system. We no need to change any code. Single program we can run on any system without changing the code. Such type of programming languages are called platform independent programming languages. Right. Next one is very important feature, which is dynamically typed programming language. Python is dynamically typed programming language. Python is dynamically typed programming language. Python is a dynamically typed programming language. You guys know already what is a dynamically typed programming language. See, if you want to write any other programming, if you want to write any program, whether it is a Java program or C program, then at the time of declaring any variable, that type compulsory required. Explicitly, we have to specify the type. If you go with other programming languages, at the time of declaring any variables, type is mandatory. Int a is equal to 10, like string s is equal to Raju, like this. That here int and string, what is this two? And int and string are these two are data types. And what these data types will represent? This a contains integer type of data. This S contains a string type of data. Like that, these types will represent what type of data is available inside the variables. These types will represent what type of data is available inside these variables. If you go for C language, C++, Java, .NET, any other programming languages, at the time of declaring variables, compulsory we have to specify the type also. At the time of declaring variables, compulsory we have to specify the type also. But coming to Python, we no need to specify the type explicitly. Directly we can take like this. We no need to specify the type explicitly. Directly we can take like this. See, here a is equal to 10 and s is equal to Raju I am taking. Here I am not taking int, string, all these types. Here I am not taking int and string like that. If you go for other programming languages, explicitly programmer has to specify the types. But coming to Python, programmer no need to specify the type explicitly. Right? If you are not specifying the type, then how it can able to understand what type of data is available inside A and S? Based on the values which we are providing at runtime, automatically it can able to understand what type of data is available inside A and S. Based on the values which we are providing at runtime, automatically it can able to understand what type of data is available inside the variables. Here I gave the value is a 10. So automatically it can able to understand, oh, this A is a integer type of variable. Here whenever we give Raju, it is right here, group of characters are there and it enclosed with the double quotes means this S is a string type of variable. Like that, based on the values which we are providing, automatically it can able to understand what is the type of the variables. We no need to specify the type explicitly like other programming languages. Such type of things are called dynamically typed programming languages. Means what? And in Python, we don't need to specify the type explicitly. Then we can say Python is a dynamically typed programming language. Right? Next one is portability. Portability. You guys have idea like, if you go with the mobile numbers and something, you guys have idea like we have mobile numbers portability and mobile number portability. Suppose if you guys are using any Airtel network, maybe in your area there is no proper signals. At that time, without changing your phone number, right? We can migrate with other network or not. You can migrate with any other network and Airtel to Vodafone, Airtel to Idea. We can able to migrate, but without changing the phone number. Such type of things are called mobile number portability. So there we are not modifying the number, just we are migrating from one network to other network. Portability means what we are doing? There we are not modifying the number, just we are migrating from one network to other network is nothing but mobile number portability. Same way, coming to our Python, Python programs are portable. Means what, Andy? We can migrate from one platform to another platform very easily. Suppose if you are using Windows, platform in the sense of Windows, Linux, Unix, all these things. We can migrate from one platform to other platform easily. Python programs will provide the same result in any platform. Right? If you run your program in Windows operating system, same result it will give. If you run your program in Unix operating system, same result you will get. If you run your program in Linux operating system, same result you will get. If you run your program in any system, you will get the same results. Easily we can migrate from one platform to other platform. Is nothing but Python programming portability. Understood? Without changing any code, we are migrating from one system to other system. Is nothing but portability. That you will get the same results in any operating system. You will get the same result in any platform. Is nothing but Python programming portability. Clear this point? Up to here, any doubts? CN, up to here, any doubts? Right, so next feature. Python will provide support to both procedure and object-oriented programming languages. Python will provide support to both procedure and object-oriented programming languages. Suppose, if you go with the C programming language, here I have C programming language and C language is there. And at the same time, I have C++ language also is there. And So now here, by using C language, what type of programs we can able to develop? And by using C language, what we can do? We can develop procedure-oriented programs. By using C language, we can develop procedure-oriented programs. It means functional-based programming. Functional-oriented programs we can develop by using C language. By using C language, we can't able to develop object-oriented programs. C language does not support to object-oriented programming. And object-oriented programming means what? Oops. Right. This C language doesn't provide support to oops concepts. By using C language, we can able to develop procedure-oriented programming only. It does not support to oops language and object-oriented programming. But coming to C++. By using C++, what type of programs we can develop? Object-oriented programs we can develop by using C++. Right, by using C++, we can develop object-oriented programming. By using C++, we can't able to develop procedure-oriented programs. Here, what point you guys have to understand? C language does not support to do object-oriented programming. C++ does not support to do procedure-oriented programming. Both are completely different. C language does not support to do object-oriented programming. C++ does not support to do procedure-oriented programming. By using C language, we can't able to develop object-oriented programs. By using C++, we can't able to develop procedure-oriented programs. But coming to Python, it will provide a support to both procedure and object-oriented programming. Means by using Python, we can develop procedure-oriented programs and we can develop object-oriented programs also. Understood? By using Python, we can develop functional based programming and object oriented programming also. But by using C language, we can develop only procedure oriented. By using C++, we can develop only object oriented programs. Clear this point? Python will provide support to both procedure and object oriented programming languages. But C language, it will provide support to only for procedure oriented. C++, it will provide support to only for object oriented programs. Then what about Java? What about Java? Java is object oriented programming language. Java is object oriented or programming language, right? Java, now current version of Java is 14, and Java 1.14 is available in market. But coming to Java, right? Before 1.8, up to 1.8 version, Java does not support to procedure oriented programs. Java up to 1.8 version, Java also does not support to procedure oriented programming. From Java 1.8 version onwards, slowly they are trying to introduce procedure oriented programming in Java also. From Java 1.8 version onwards, they are adding procedure oriented concepts in Java also. Up to Java 1.8, there is no procedure oriented kind of things in Java. Java does not provide support to functional programming up to 1.8. From 1.8 version onwards, Java people also started introducing this functional oriented programming concepts in Java also slowly. They are not put all the things and slowly, version by version, some procedure oriented concepts they are adding in Java also. Right, in Java 1.8, functional programming came. Lambda expressions came in Java from 1.8 version onwards. But coming to Python, from day one onwards, 1991, from day one onwards, Python will provide support to both procedure and object oriented programming languages. Clear this point? Please confirm, clear this point? Python will provide support to both procedure and object oriented programs. Right, so one more important feature is Python is interpreted programming language. Interpreted programming language. What is interpreted programming language? Already we discussed it. Interpreted programming language means we are not required to compile our program explicitly. Right? If you go for Java, if you go for C, if you go for C++, after writing the program, we have to do two activities. What two activities we have to do? One is compilation and another one is execution. Compilation and execution. Both we have to do in other programming languages. But coming to Python, we are not required to compile Python program explicitly. Internally, Python interpreter will take care of that compilation also. Directly as a programmer, directly we can run our program, that compilation and all the things internally my interpreter will take care. As a programmer, we don't need to worry about that. Understood? In Python program, we are doing only one activity, which is nothing but execution. And internally, interpreter is there, that interpreter will take care of that compilation and all the things. As a programmer, we no need to compile the Python program explicitly. But if you go with other programming languages, programmer needs to compile the program explicitly. Programmer needs to compile the program explicitly. If you go for C, C++, Java, programmer only compile the program explicitly. But coming to Python, programmer no need to compile the program explicitly. Directly, programmer can run our program internally. Interpreter will take care of that compilation and all those things. Clear? Right here, compilation and execution, two things are there, Andy. If you go with other programming languages, if you go with other programming languages like C, C++, Java, programmer needs to explicitly compile the program. Right? Then only that high level program will convert into low level program. Right? System can able to understand only low level program and all the things will happen. And but coming to say Andy, at the time of compilation, right, if you go for C language and C++, right, memory allocation is allowed at the time of compilation only. In C and C++, memory will be allocated at the time of compilation only. But coming to Java and Python, memory will be allocated at the time of execution, at the time of runtime. This point also we have to remember. Memory allocation will be happened at the time of compilation for C and C++. Memory allocation will be performed at the time of compilation only for C and C++ programming languages. And if you want to run your program, compulsory your program should be stored in some location, and then only you can able to run. Right? Memory allocation compulsory required. And that memory allocation will be performed at the time of compilation only for C and C++. Right? If the memory is allocated at compilation time, then such type of programming languages are called static programming languages. Memory will be allocated at compilation time only means such type of programming languages are called static programming languages. Next, for Java and Python, memory will be allocated at runtime. Then these programming languages are called dynamic programming languages. Both the people, Lahari, you are also not getting the screen. Please respond. You are also not getting the screen, Lahari. Okay. Ramchandra, problem at your end only. Reconnect otherwise. Right. Here Python is interpreted programming language, and so means what? And interpreted programming languages means programmer no need to compile the program explicitly, explicitly, internally, interpreter will take care the compilation. Python is interpreted programming language means what? Programmer no need to compile the program explicitly. Internally, my interpreter will take care of that compilation. As a programmer, just we have to run the program explicitly. As a programmer, just we have to run the program explicitly. This is the additional step. Memory location will be performed at the time of compilation only for C and C language, C++. Such a type of programming languages are called static programming languages. For Java and Python, memory will be allocated at the time of program runtime and at the time of runtime. Such a type of programming languages are called dynamic programming languages. Right. Right, so next feature is extensible. Next feature is extensible and extensible. Extensible means what? And see here, I'm writing one Python program. Here I'm writing one Python program like this. And here I am writing Python program. See, this is my Python program. This is my Python program. So now I want to provide security to my Python program. I want to provide security for my Python program. For that, what you have to do? You have to write that security related logic also in your program. You have to write security related logic also in your program. But the problem is, by using Python, I can't able to write that much of security related logic. That much of good security related logic I can't able to write by using Python. Here, this is the Python program, and here what I wrote, everything is Python code only. Here what I wrote, that code, everything is Python code only. And now what I want to do for this Python program, I want to provide security. And I want to provide security. But by using this Python code, I can't able to write that much good security logic. But if you give the chance, by using C language, I can able to write good security related logic. I can able to write good security logic by using C language if you give the chance. In that case, okay, no problem. Go and develop that security logic in C language only. Go and develop that security related logic in C language. So here what I'm doing now, by using Python, I can't able to implement that much of good security logic. But if you give the chance, by using C programming language, I can able to implement a good security logic. Then go and develop that security logic by using C programming language only. Later, after completing developing that security logic, use that C program inside your Python program. Use that C program inside your C Python program, no worries. Here, extensible means what? And we can use other language programs also inside Python. This is the C language program. C language program I'm using inside our Python programming. Understood? Extensible means we are extending our Python program by adding other language programs also inside our Python program. Extensible means what?
we are extending our Python program by adding other language programs inside Python. This is the C language programming. This is security concept. The security stuff is related to C language program. So that C language program I'm including inside my Python program. Understood? Extensible in the sense what? And we can add other language programs also inside our Python program is nothing but extensible. If you do like this, happily we can improve the performance of the application. If you have this kind of feature, happily we can improve the performance of the application. What we are doing, we are extending our Python programming language by adding other language programs also inside Python is nothing but extensible. Next feature. Embedded. What is meant by this embedded? Here what we are doing? We are adding other language programs inside our Python program. Same way, we can use Python programs. In any other language programs also. So this is the C programming language. Inside this C programming language, I am embedding this Python program. We can use our Python program inside a other language program also. Reverse it. Extensive means what? We are extending our Python program by adding other language programs inside our Python. Embedded means what? We can add our Python program into any other language program also. Reverse it. We can embed our Python program into any other language programs. See, here I am using this Python program inside a C language. Extensive means what we are doing. This is a C language program I am using inside Python. Vice versa. Reverse it. Clear what is extensible and what is embedded? Extensible means we can use other language programs inside our Python program. Embedded means we can use our Python program into any other language programs. Embedded and extensible. Next one. Next feature is extensive libraries. Here we have so many libraries are available in Python. If you install Python in your system, you will get a lot of inbuilt libraries. You will get so many inbuilt libraries here. Being a programmer, we can use those libraries directly in our program. Just import those libraries. And we can use the functionalities which are available inside those libraries in our program. Right here, whenever you installed Python in your system, you will get a lot of inbuilt libraries also. Being a programmer, what we can do, we can include those libraries, we can import those libraries in our program. And what functionality is available inside those libraries, those functionalities happily we can use in our program. Understood? If you install Python in your system, you will get a lot of libraries, thousands of libraries you will get. Being a programmer, import those libraries in your program. And what functionalities are available inside those libraries, those functionality you can use inside your program. Simple example. I have math module. See what I will do. 1 minute.
I will show. I'll show example. Give me 1 minute. See, here I want to find out square root of 400. Square root of 400. Immediately will return name square. It is not defined. Name square root SQRT is not defined. Then what you have to write? You have to write a code, and some code we have to write to get that square root of 400. Here what it is returning? Name square it is not defined. Not defined. You have to write some logic. You have to write some logic and array. Why we need to write the logic? This is square root mathematical functionality. Is already available in one library. That library we are getting whenever you install Python in your system. That library you are getting happily. Import that library in your program. Import that library in your program, and inside that library, this square root function is available. So happily you can use that square root function. Otherwise, unnecessarily we have to write a lot of code to get a square root of this 400. Explicitly, you have to write lot of code to get this square root of 400. Instead of that, what I will do? See and here, what I will do? Import a math module. We have math module, and what this math module contains? All mathematical related functions, all mathematical related things are available inside this math. And whenever you install Python in your system, automatically you will get this math. You will get this math. And inside this, what we have, all square root function, seal function, float function, all those things are available. Now here what I am doing, I am importing that math. Now here what I will do, math dot sqrt of 4. CRT 2.0 it is returning. Am I writing any logic here to get a square root and sqrt 4? To get sqrt 4, am I writing any logic? No. Already this square root function is implemented inside this math module like this. Already square root function is implemented inside this math module. Here what I am doing, just I am importing that math module inside my program. Inside math module, square root function is there. That function I am using it here. That function I am using it here to get the square root of a number like this inside Python. If you install Python, you will get thousands of libraries. As a programmer, happily we can import those libraries in our program, and what functionalities are available inside those libraries, we can use those functionalities in our program also. Understood? So we have separate topic, modules topic is there, and there I will discuss in detail how to import the modules, how to import particular member from the module, and all these things. And like the math module, I will take some examples related to this math module, and I will take some examples related to random module. All the things I will explain at the time of discussing modules concept. We have separate topic, modules is there. At the time I will discuss in detail about these things. And like here, just to remember, Python, if you install Python in your system, you will get thousands of libraries and all those things. If you import those things in your program, happily we can use the functionalities which are available inside those modules in our program also. What is the advantage? And if you do like this, code reusability. Unnecessarily, we don't need to write more code. And already someone is implemented. Happily, we can use those concepts. We don't need to rewrite the code again. Understood? This feature also available in Python, right? So these are the different features. These are the several features we have in Python. See, once again, we'll go through all these things. One minute. See, and these are the several features are available in Python, and right. First, once again, we'll go through the features once again and see. Python is a simple and easy programming language. And Python is simple and easy programming language means what? And easily learn Python. Python syntaxes. Syntaxes are very easy compared with other programming languages. It looks like simple English language. Anyone can able to read and understand. Correct or not? Python is very easy to learn, and Python syntaxes are very easy compared with other programming languages, and it looks like simple English language. Anyone can able to read and understand this Python programming. Correct or not? Python is a simple and easy programming language because of these things, and right. So next, it is freeware, and right, to work with Python, you no need to pay single NP also to anyone. It is completely free. And one more point, open source. And once you install Python in your system, you can able to see the source code, and it is customizable. It is customized, and you can customize based on your requirement. Right, to work with Python, you no need to pay single NP also to anyone, and it is completely freeware. It is completely freeware. Happily you can install and you can develop any kind of applications. Once you install Python in your system, you can able to see the source code, and you can customize based on your requirement also. Clear? Next point, and Python is a high level programming language, and Python is a high level programming language means what, and right, anyone can able to understand, and it is more readable, and it is a more readable, and anyone can able to understand and read also. Right, next, Python is a platform independent, and means what? We can run our Python program in any platform without changing the code. We can run our Python program in any platform without changing the code. And suppose if you write the Python program in Windows operating system, tomorrow you can able to use same program in Unix operating system also without changing any code. And
Next, you can use same program in Linux operating system also. Next, you can use in any other operating system also without changing the code. And such type of programming languages are called platform independent programming languages. Then Java and Python, these are the platform independent programming languages. And platform dependent means C and C++. These are the platform dependent programming languages. Next, Python is a dynamically typed programming language. Means see here an example is there clearly. Right. In other programming languages, at the time of declaring any variables, explicitly we have to specify the type also. But coming to Python, we no need to specify the type explicitly. It can able to understand automatically based on the values which we are providing at the runtime. Clear? Next point is a portability. Portability means what? We can migrate one system to other system easily. We can migrate one system to other system easily without having any code changes. Without having any code changes, we can migrate one system to other system easily is nothing but portability. Without changing mobile number, how we can able to migrate one network to other network? Here also, without changing any code, we can migrate from one system to other system is nothing but portability. Next, Python will provide support to both procedure and object-oriented programming languages. Here, if you go for C language is the procedure-oriented programming language. If you go with C++, that is the object-oriented programming language. By using C language, we can't able to develop object-oriented programs. By using C++, we can't able to develop procedure-oriented programs. But by using Python, we can develop both procedure and object-oriented programming. By using Python, we can develop both procedure and object-oriented programming. Next, Python is interpreted programming language. As a programmer, we no need to compile the Python program. Directly, we can run our program explicitly. If you go for other programming languages, programmer is responsible to compile the programs explicitly. But in Python, we no need to compile our program explicitly. Directly, we can run our program. Internally, my interpreter will take care of that compilation and everything. Python is an interpreter programming language. So here we are using interpreter. So that interpreter will take care internally the compilation and everything. As a programmer, we no need to worry about compilation. Directly, that source code, whatever we wrote, that code we can able to run. Next one, extensible. Extensible means what? We can use, simple and we can use other language programs inside our Python program. We can use other language programs inside our Python program. Right? Extensible means we are extending our Python program by adding other language programs also inside our Python program. Right? So next one is embedded. We can add our Python program into any other language program also. We can add our Python program into any other language program. Right? Extensible means what we are doing? We are adding other language programs inside our Python program. Embedded means what we are doing? we are adding our Python program into any other language program also. Reverse we are doing. Extensive libraries means once you install Python software in your system, you will get thousands of libraries. Happily, we can import those things in our program. Whatever the functionalities are available inside those libraries, those functionalities we can use inside our program also. Clear? Any explanation is required about these features? Any explanation is required? Please respond. Right, please go through these features once again. Clear, right? All features, 11 features. Right? Very good. Right. So, remaining things we'll discuss in next class. Okay? Thank you, guys.